أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Dear friends, how many of the ideas and beliefs we carry and it is not supported by scientific evidence, which can lead to disasters? So it is a big responsibility for those who carry these beliefs, which can lead to unintended or undesired consequences. Take the vaccine, which based on one report of some crooked person to spread the fear and of vaccines and cause a lot of deaths for children who were not immunized against diphtheria and mumps and so on. Take the issue of denying the climate change, though all the scientific evidence tell us there is global warming and there is major changes in the Arctic and Antarctic poles and the ozone layer and the acid rain and you name it, and you still find people denying that. Let us not mention the landing on the moon and the earth is not flat and so on, and a lot of ideas there. And the internet facilitated the communication among peoples, and that's why you have tons of conspiracy theories which should be faced by intelligent skepticism. When it comes to things which can harm, like the issue of OxyContin, the company knew that it can cause addiction to drugs, including heroin and more than that, and they continue to ignore that fact, which is based on science, and continue to sell in billions of dollars that medicine, which caused a lot of suffering in several of the states with skyrocketing suicide and other crimes. So any belief without sufficient scientific evidence, we need to be careful and to hold judgments. And it becomes very dangerous when it comes to the religion and the sects and the groups where everyone has a set of dogmas and he thinks himself God instrument on earth, and he started judging people and started acting on those beliefs, which can be argued very simply to be false. And that led to wars. And fortunately in Europe, they learned the lesson and they live in together and they don't care anymore about Huguenots and this and that, and probably still existing, but among the groups, and it doesn't spill over to something big. But in the Middle East, they are killing people based on not talking or discussing, based on the ID card. And this is really very dangerous. And this is one of the things the atheists take against religions, that it is divisive, and it is violent, and it leads to killing and other terrible crimes against humanity. Of course, when it comes to religions, we understand there's 4,200 major religions and smaller ones and sects and cults, you name it. But all of these cannot be true, because the truth is one. And It's a human reflection on understanding the truth and the ultimate truth, which is God. Here, there is an anomaly to the scientific discoveries and so on. It's by design. God is not here in among us in our worldly material life. God is God, nothing unto him, all seeing, all hearing. ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. قل هو الله أحد. الله الصمد. لم يلد ولم يولد. ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. So here, William James, an American philosopher of the late 19th century, beginning of 20th century, he is telling us, as long as the belief is based on live option and forced option and momentous option, it is acts like a scientific evidence. So, at any rate, as long as things become or discussed or confessed in a civilized manner with a lot of love and compassion, it's not a big deal for everyone to, you know, believe that he's right and everyone is wrong. But when it spills over to the ugliest of the ugly, the religious wars, what happened in Europe in the 100-year war and 30-year war, and ethnic and religious cleansing, especially the Huguenot, the Protestant in France. This is very ugly part of the history of mankind. And nowadays we are repeating the same thing in the Middle East. May God guide us and give us the wisdom to solve our problems peacefully and to have understanding and to live in harmony and work hard and improve on our lives and the lives of our children and grandchildren. May God bless you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.